Bravissimo. Excellent, excellent. Okay, now, this area is one of the most difficult areas concerning the intonation. It's full of minors, diminished, etc., 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 plus a very light accompaniment. I mean, the piano is too much of an accompaniment. If you sing it with the orchestra and there is the harp underneath, maestro, I think, forget it. You do not hear a thing. And if the orchestra and the conductor are good, you should not hear anything on stage. So it has all, the whole harmony has to be your mind. You sang perfectly well the first phrase, and it was very good intonation-wise. Yeah, oh, the beginning, the departure, etc. Now, what I think happened, because after that, you sang soft piano, the first exposition or exposure of the theme. When you come to the main part of the aria and you have to give your full voice, the fact of the piano singing at the beginning brought you a little bit out of the road. So when you try to fill up the voice with the whole resonances, most of the time, a lot of times it remained underneath. It did not got the pitch perfectly well. Of course, we must remember that this aria comes at the end of the opera, which means that the body is already, the whole system, very, very, very well warmed, and just the 15 minutes vocalizing cannot make up for not having sung the rest of the opera. Though, on the other hand, you may arrive at the end of the opera with this aria and be tired, so somehow it balances. Anyway, keep in mind that the moment you start filling up the voice, let me get my glasses. Fantastic, all this exposure here. Then you come here, and you start feeling as you should. Use this rest here in order to find in your body the new, almost the new position and support to sing all this with the pitch right in the middle. Let's forget the first part, and let's start from here. And whenever I hear something that needs to be corrected, I'm going to interrupt. Okay. Cruda Sventura. Okay. A little bit before that. Okay, this Sventura, it was before, it's not high enough. The pitch has to be more in the middle. Could you please play for her the chord underneath the chord? Tune it a little bit. Okay, and then be careful that I think the astringe is another, it's a different chord. No, it's the same. Okay. Let's do it again. That was it. Yes. Sorry, another thing, of course Italian music and Verdi, etc., you are allowed and you need and must do portati. Though I would say, let's make as little as possible. Mm-hmm. Of course the portati sometimes give a rest to the voice and the breath. But this point here I would prefer, the portato also means expressively that, how do you say cedere? Giving up, giving up. Yeah. She doesn't give up here. Cruda sventura, ma stringe in mio languir. You don't need to cedere, to give up here. Cruda sventura, ma stringe in mio languir. Oh, excellent. You saw now these portati were very well, very much needed, because there you give up patch and the others must stringe on my langour. There is a wrath, she's angry at God and the fate, la forza del destino, il destiny. She's angry, so she should not give up. But there in the pace was perfect. Okay, let's go on. But of course, it's a matter of conductor. There is a portato towards the higher note, yeah. Which many yeah. times we do it, right?
Okay. Yes, that'd be traditional.
Yes, if you need it, codando.
Listen,
Caterina, listen. If you steal a breath before the lorno, the way you have learned, you keep everything here on place, do a quick movement of the ribs, you get fresh air, and nobody knows that you're taking a breath. That's what Caballé usually does. And you say, oh my God, how could she go from there to there? She does this very, very clever little breaths in between. I would say, try to steal, but not really, lorno, but just stop for a moment, for just a very small moment, your sound. Get your ribs out, get fresh air, and go on.
La
maille. La maille. The orno to the ke, do not arrive with the orno to the fa, to the nota fa, and then repeat it for the ke. Just go, l'orno ke, not l'orno ke, l'orno ke. Okay, do you agree? I think it's better like that way. Yes, yes. We don't. Do not really make a quite obvious and proper fa and then repeat it for the ke. We don't need to do it now.
Okay.
Unless you want, we can go on. I don't need it, just a small, you want to do it?
Yeah.
All right, fine. The portati at the phrase before, well, perfect. Now, I would not do the portati this June. Where exactly did you do it? I wouldn't do it. Just keep the phrase clear and simple. You don't need to do it. And also it spoils the very precious to the Italians effect of the double consonant T. Mm-hmm. If you do the portato, you lose it a little bit.
So
double T. Double T. Delito. Sorry, sorry. Are you sure in your mind how you deal to do the double T? Do you know how to do it technically? All right, do it then. Alvaro could stay underneath, although up to now you were perfectly in your pitch, all this section. This Alvaro could stay underneath the pitch and create a problem afterwards. Please make sure the Alvaro is, the note is well focused and centered.
Alvaro?
Please give her the chords, the Alvaro, the chords. What is the problem? Although, as we know, the fifth is what it is, the first note of the chord is a little bit higher, the third even more higher. There are sometimes some notes who are lower in frequency, but for some reason which I cannot explain, some scientists should explain that to us, they feel heavy. They feel heavy, and we tend either to make them too low. One must be very careful because those rather lower frequencies, okay, they for some reason are more difficult. I can't explain you physically and scientifically why. So I think this is one of those notes, and it's a very special support in order to be well centered. Well said. All this phrase Alvaro Iotamo e sunel cielo scritto non ti vedrò mai più could be sung softer and not with dramatic impact. Can we do it from the orchestra maestro? Is it light enough to make this phrase softer? It's more, she's close to tears, okay? So it would be Alvaro, but Alvaro io t'amo, e su nel cielo scritto. More complaining, more ready to collapse and to fall in tears than dramatic. You have space afterwards for the dramatic things. Try it again. Well tuned Alvaro, but all soft and ready to collapse from. And now all your dramatic impact. Now change. The difference. The first one is like sung angelically, and then it comes this, oh dear, somebody kill me, I can't stand this life anymore. Give us this difference. It was very well sung, but now I want to see the dramatic impact afterwards. You start wherever you please.
So where we go from, that was very beautiful, by the way.
It was very beautiful, yes. It was very beautiful. Yes, and then I want to see this.
Kill me.
suggest here, what do you think, maestro, to do the duo? In preda tanto, 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 duo, to connect it. Would you agree? She cuts after the dual and then...
Yeah, because one way, many people do it that way. In preda tanto, tanto, duo. You can just do it as written.
In preda tanto, tanto, duo. Yes. No, you can make it. You don't need practically to make a fermata there.
No.
But I think it's good that has written this effect that you go whoa. It's like if you were acting it, you would say it's so much pain that, and she doesn't find another word. It's like the sol bemol. Mm-hmm. She would go on higher. To tell us that this dual she feels this pain is even bigger, though she can't find the word, so she drops. Mm-hmm. This is why he connects, I think, the mi bemol with the sol bemol. Okay.
But also, you can move it back.
Yes, move it.
Move.
And actually, I can still also I mezzo tanto 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 dual. It's not tired. Bravo. Okay. And now, excuse me, another one, not that she needed, she did fine, but just to be aware, if you perform on stage or you have the whole opera in your back, your body is, you know, this dramatic moments, one must be very careful of his personal emotional involvement, okay? You find emotional involvement in the rehearsals, so you know how you express it with your voice. But when you are on stage, you are very careful, because if you get involved improperly emotionally too much, then you might lose the control on the voice. Okay, you must be very careful up to that point.
So we go.
Relax all your body and get good the intonation and the harmonical change. Natural. The fa was perfect and you got the mi bemol perfectly, but the in between was a bit unsteady. Now, it was much better than the first time, but let's clear up this harmonical change here. With okay. Have it very clear, it was not bad, it was very, but let's say, Ambici as a recording producer, okay? Even if it was very, very good, and if you sing it on stage like that, public is going to fall down, the recording producer would ask you to do it again. Because this note, the change, when the other chord comes underneath the C bemol, the change of your note was not perfect, okay? You must have it very good in your ears. Just give it one more try. Play, please, for her the chords with the note on top of it, the change. The first.
You want to sing it that way?
No, let me see. Okay. We are here. We have this, and then we go. And it's interesting because always when they are harmony, is the emotional base of what we sing. It's you see, he starts this, which is a minor. He goes on the high B flat with a major, and staying on the B flat, he changes again on the minor. Okay. It's what does this mean to me? That she wishes the peace that she will find in death. So when she first hits the word peace, pace, her first the beginning of the note is very positive. I want the peace of the death. And then comes the minor and say, but why should I die so young? And so you see that instead of, if he wanted her to be completely sure, I mean, if she would after that jump from the rock to the sea, like the Suliotis says, he would have stayed on the major. Instead, she doesn't do it. She doesn't kill herself. Things come in a way that she gets killed at the end. But she does not, although she wishes it, she doesn't do it. So she wishes that also because now being a nun, she knows that she should not wish for death. Because this is a sin. So you start on the major, but be very, very aware of this minor coming on the same top note that you are. Just give it one try. And always keep in mind that this is a very, very, and what comes after that harmonically is very difficult, but you sang it very, very well. No objection to that. Just this one, once more. Yes, but give her the sequence, please, from the beginning. So, yes. Okay. Just do not look at the notes, you know it. Just close your eyes and concentrate in the harmony. Okay. Bravissima. That's another thing. I have that was perfect, wasn't it?
It
was perfect now.
You know, the way they do the words, if you take a breath, is not the way you're doing it. They take,
yes, exactly. That's what I wanted to say.
Alma in van la.
Okay.
Okay?
Mm-hmm.
Like that. And then you can breathe after Alma. Alma in van.
Bravo, that's what I want to say. Good. Don't do the B flats now, from after the B flats.
Try in van la pace.
This was not the one we want to do.
Did you want the B flat?
No, I want this Alma. I didn't like the way she put the syllables here. Viva la voce, Alma. Let me hear how you sing it, I don't remember.
Thank you.
go. No, it's a mistake. Ma che giunge?
It's a mistake.
Yes. Heard it before, yes.
Ma che giunge?
This, yes, this is a dun, 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 dun. Yeah, because I had it, and I also saw that she was not happy with it.
Yeah,
like,
no,
she felt like it was,
yeah.
Is it or is it not? Should be like this. Yes. So it's up to you.
It goes much faster.
Bravo. It's spoken.
If you have a maestro, it's okay. But if you don't, you have to know yourself. It's fast.
It's in due.
You do it as for you, that's comfortable, but you have to do it. I can't do it.
And that's that. This is what he meant as well. That's why he puts a tremolo and he lets you speak. On your own emotional speed, which is different from you to me to I don't know who else. Okay.
Yeah, exactly as you said,
in due. But even this due is different.
Yes.
Different. This is why you have a tremolo and the conductor, the accompanist is going to follow. No, I would say directly so ma che giunge.
Or let's make the change. La
yes.
Sol, sola, la vita.
Take 1-2 minutes of rest. Take a little bit of rest, and we'll go to the next one. Thank you. Bellissima. Very good. With a real Falcone voice, right, maestro?
Yes.
Soprano Falcone. What? Don't tell me again I'm afraid of something, because I'm going to slap your face this time. Oh, okay. All right. Yeah. Excellent. Very, very good. Very nice, dark quality as demanded. Now, in comparison with the day before I heard you, I heard too many spread notes in the middle high register. You managed very, very well the B flat. Okay. But the notes with where are the solo, the la bemol, whatever, I hear them a little spread in comparison with what I know from your voice from the other days. Does this have to do with the fact that you probably over darkened in order to master this very low tessitura? Okay, let's take it from the beginning. As I said, I'm bitchy as a recording producer, not as a public audience who would go, you know, crazy about the way you sang it. Only with the very sensitive ear of the microphone, where every small detail becomes very amplified. And this is our purpose, to eliminate as many as possible of those small details. Now, let's go from the beginning. Start as you started. Keep in mind, your harmony understanding of the French repertoire, as we said the other day, is very, very good. I have nothing to, maybe one or two places, which could also be by chance. I mean, not that there's something wrong. Keep in mind that when you sing this melody, it's the beginning melody, ta-ri-ra-ri-pa-pa. I personally think that the French composers, many times when they write these melodies, they think like lideristic, how do you say?
Songwriters.
So it should not be sung with the approach of the Italian verismo. Although we are very close to the verismo, right? It's harmony, tessitura, etc. Though the approach of the French composer, when he has a melody, the main melody of his aria, should be approached much more like a lead, a melody. That means that all has to be more elegant, more subtle, and do not allow notes. You sing in the lower register, you start in the lower register, and then there is a note in the middle, the high medium, and this goes out of your line. I will show this to you on place. Let's start from the pleurer mes yeux directly, from the melody. And try to think that this is a Saint-Saëns melody, or a Massenet melody, and not a big aria, you know. That was very good. Brava, brava. That was very good. Very good. Yes, yes. And kept the line and would not have notes sticking out because they were higher up, etc. That was very, very good. Then, another part I want to see. In the middle part, there is a moment where she goes up chromatically. I don't know if this one is another one. Where I felt that she was not. Was it here?
Here.
No. Yes, let's make very sure, although it's quite complicated underneath, make very sure that you have the harmonic changes right in your ear, and so your harmonic way of going up.
Where it's where we say,
yes, Okay. Okay. Yes, you must have very clear the harmonic changes underneath, so that it's all right, because there are one or two places which I felt they were not they were not right, because you were not sure what the harmony underneath was. Okay, so let's clean this up.
So I give you.
You have to give the surire right, push it downwards, because it's tending to go a little bit higher, this surire, and then be very clear about the harmonic change from the ja to the me. Do it on your own. Do not go on the fa and expect to hear the harmony from the piano and then change. Make us understand, even without the piano, that there is a harmonic change there. It's very important. Okay, let's do it again. Okay, now can you give us an echo, if possible? It would be a very lovely effect if you, repeating the main theme, Pleure mes yeux, you give us an echo of the first time, if possible. Excellent. And this pleure make the Arabic crescendo. That was very, very good. As you did it now. And there the pleure, get again to fill up your voice with a bigger. Do only the crescendo. I don't want the other one. It was fantastic.